This is the Green Union as it is at the moment. Back wheel out. That's the original rear wheel for it there, which has a single speed back pedal brake and the Westrick type pattern rim. So it's got a front wheel in it from something else. I think it's from an 80s Superb actually, because it's got the stainless rim. Although no, it's not. That's a Vineman rim. That's not a Van Schothorst. So goodness knows what that's come out of. It won't be a Gazelle because it hasn't got a drum brake. If you remember, I had to drill through the fork crown. That was a monster drilling job. That went through a few of my old bits, and I fitted your standard Vineman single pivot caliper brake, which is actually the one that came off my 85 Superb when I put the wheel in, the Gazelle wheel that was in here. So it's been a bit of a nepotistic swapping around. So I'm putting its original single speed rear wheel with back pedal brake, which means I move the tyre out of the way, I've been able to denude the frame a little bit. So all the extra, the Sturmey Archer pivot wheel, the fulcrum clip, the white plastic cable clips for the brake cable, they've all been stripped off. So no brake cable now, no gear cable now. So the frame looks lovely. I'll show you when I've finished it. You can appreciate the very laid back lines of the frame. So of course we're down to one brake lever on the handlebars now as well. And yes, I've put a pair of wooden grips on, of course I have. I simply like coloured ash ones. So this is the one other job I've got to do before we get the Elizabethans in. So you have been, once I got a little bit hacked off with the maroon Superb, or with the news of the expanded task, first thing I did really was finish the red folder, the red 20, sorry, it's not a folder, I'd have kept it if it was. Yeah, I finished the red 20, did the trade with the Elizabethan, and meanwhile, I just pulled this out, finished drilling that hole, and thought, oh, I might as well just get these cables off here and make it how it originally was, put the original front wheel back in, original back wheel back in. Sorry, I'm tired. Yeah, so I'm going to crack on with this, and then the next thing you know, it'll be finished, and I'll probably take it for a ride and get on with these Curry's Elizabethans, because I'm anxious to get on with them. So here's the Union back out again. It definitely looks different to my eyes, having the cables taken off it. Much more Dutch, much more pure, apart from of course having the caliper brake on it. For those who don't know, I've said it before, but for anyone outside the UK who probably doesn't know, bikes in the UK have to have two separate brakes. A fixed wheel is classed as a brake, so you can have a fixie with a brake, or a coaster brake with a brake, as in this case, but you must have two brakes. You could even have God, they're noisy, aren't they? Modern bikes are so noisy. You can even have a caliper and a drum brake on the same wheel. They don't even have to be on separate wheels, but you have to have two brakes. So I've got the caliper on there, but to be honest, the thing that the uninitiated often don't realise about coaster brakes, back pedal brakes, is that they're very, very good. You're using the most powerful muscles in your body, and you've got your big long legs as as pushers. And of course your lever is, you know, 160, 170 millimeters long. That's your brake lever that you're pushing down on with your foot. So you can get a massive amount of braking. Think of the dawn of mountain biking, those guys going down the mountains in, you know, old Schwinns and things. That's what they had. They had a coaster brake like that. And the race that they organised was called the repack, because you used to have to repack your hub with grease at the bottom of every descent because you burned out all the grease. So that indicates a massive amount of power generated, and you sure can. Another thing I like about them is the modulation. You can modulate your braking very finely. So in town, I really rate them. It frees a hand up for hand signals as well, you know. And coupled with single speed, which they almost always are, although I do have a Sax Torpedo 3-speed with coaster brake going into my Gazelle Populaire. Yeah, but when it's coupled with a single speed, you've got a real simplicity in town, because you're not thinking about changing gear, you don't have the option. So you soon forget about the concept of gears and you just ride along. So yeah, I do rate single speeds, even though until recently I've had precious few. So now this is single. The new Path Racer will be single, as was the old one. Not fixed. I'm not into fixed. I know it has its cult following, who sometimes do behave like a cult if you dare to raise a word of negativity, like put a front brake on. There's an element in the Fixie Brigade who do behave like cult members. Yeah, I've not really been into Fixie myself. I've had a couple, obviously, you know, Victorian Edwardian bikes. Just not my cup of tea, you know. Just as these things aren't most people's cup of tea who are into road bikes and other types of bikes. We all have our bag, man. Anyway, there's the Union back on the road. Looking great without its cables, I think. And a brief conversation on Facebook last week with one of my Facebook friends about the frame angles on these old Dutch bikes. The chap was looking at a picture of a genuine old British bike, a Sunbeam I think it was, and saying that he'd love to ride a bike that has these really laid back angles. And I said, well, get an old Dutch bike. As long as it's a proper traditional one, there you go. There's your 60 something degree frame angles, your long fork offset, your long wheelbase. It's all there. It's your Edwardian bicycle, really, with very little upgrade. When you consider, you can get bikes like this right now. You can get the Gazelle Populaire. You can go out tomorrow and buy one. And you go back 120 years immediately. Just stop for a brief chat with one of the local Greyhound people. So, I'm going to go and enjoy this now. I have an adjustment to make. For some reason, the bracket of the bell has got pushed out, so the bell is further away from the tyre than I would like. So when I pull the bell lever on the dashboard, on the handlebars, it's not meeting the tyre, so I need to adjust that. When I say adjust, you know I mean bend, don't you? Coaster brakes also very useful for this. One-handed with my camera down here. Thank you. I've got my foot braking. I've got my hand on the lever and I've got my foot on the other brake. Full control. The sunshine's gone today, We've had a few thunderstorms. I also don't have my wind noise suppressor out with me. If you're getting any wind noise, I apologise. I'll try and edit it out. A single speed also has the advantage of always being in direct drive, so there aren't any friction losses like there is in a hub gear when it's not in direct drive. Fortunately, in a Sturmey Archer 3-speed, second gear is direct drive, so beetling about like this I would be in second, but even so, it's another thing about single speed. Yeah, the history of this damage is that this bike has been in an Amsterdam canal, and the city council have this thing where they dredge the canals, obviously for, you know, they're very busy with boat traffic, but they also have a special barge with one of these five-fingered hydraulic grabs like you see in scrap metal yards, and they'll come along on the barge, dunk it in the water, close it up and just bring out whatever they bring out, and then have another barge floating alongside, the drop comes and drops them into the other barge. this bike had been through that process. So the top tube was down here like that. The wheels were completely toast. So the rear wheel was like heart-shaped and the mudguard and carrier were right down with it. Front wheel was missing, front mudguard was folded down, and the handlebars were completely mangled and mashed with a big flat section. And there was a flat section in here as well. But I saw something in it. I think the reason it didn't just go into scrap metal, I think maybe the person had reclaimed it or something. I'm not quite sure of that middle step. But when I was told that it had been through the barge, I completely got that story, because the damage was exactly commensurate to it having been lifted up like that. And when I've seen the bikes that have been done, they look the same. In fact, there are videos on YouTube, Amsterdam Bike Fisherman, I recommend it. Hilarious viewing and amazing as well. So yeah, this bike had been through that. If you've seen other videos about this bike, I tend to mention it most times. The reason being that people ask about the top tube, so I always try and explain. So it's such a survivor, I think it deserves to survive and continue surviving. And that's why I put a bit of effort into what to Dutch people is a piece of scrap. I'm sure Rolling Random is watching this thinking, why do you bother? It's a piece of, well, what he calls spikes on his channel. Yeah, I've seen him cut gazelles up for scrap and put them in his scrap metal bin. It's a different perspective. Someone in Netherlands, this is just an old scrap bike. And the same reason that people in other countries really value some of the British bikes that we don't put so much value on. We're beginning now to value the rallies, but in many other countries the rallies have been very highly revered for years, when they were just £10 piece of scrap in this country. And I think that's where we are with the older Dutch bikes. Until they get properly old and become old-timer fietsen, they go through this phase of just being old bikes and not valued, because they're so plentiful, they're street furniture. So they are literally just laid around. Not so much in Amsterdam now, because Amsterdam has become such a tourist theme park. Even I'm disappointed in it these days. But certainly, oh, I've just gone the wrong way. Whenever I talk about this topic, I get people asking, how do you find bikes like this? Do you just go out on the street and just get them? Well, you could once upon a time, but we're past that now. As I said, particularly in Amsterdam, tourist theme park, all been cleaned up, etc. And the Amsterdammers mostly moving over to e-bikes now, so there should be a glut of this kind of thing. And my recommendation is to go out of the capital and to look on the Amsterdam equivalent of well, not eBay, the Amsterdam equivalent of Gumtree, which is Marktplaats. Go and look on Marktplaats. There are things like this all over the place. And as I say, modest values, not you know, not 10, 20 euros, that sort of thing. We're talking about a reasonable price. But they come up every day in remarkable condition. If you want to find a gazelle with little use that's been cosseted, outside of the capital is the place. Utrecht, I think, should be happy hunting ground. Paul Larrabee will know about that. Again, there is a reputation in the capital for bikes being trashed by being owned by 15 consecutive students and used as currency and that sort of thing. So go into the provinces if you want a nice one. Even just a little way out, even just to Haarlem, any of those small cities, look on Marktplaats and happy hunting, and let me know what you find. Better still, you're on YouTube, that means you've got a YouTube profile. Make a little video. Start doing this, it's fun. Right, I'm getting back to the workshop now. See you later, bye bye. There we are, the classic beta bike saddle cover. I think I'm going to enjoy using this for the local errand runs for a little while.